Hello everyone, I welcome all the students of class 9 in my next session. I hope you all are doing very good at home, you all are safe inside. And today, as our chapter is completed, we will talk about our poem, The Road Not Taken. This is the poem written by Robert Frost, and this is the one of my favorite poem, The Road Not Taken. Robert Frost, he is an American poet, and he always writes about the topic that touches our life. And this is a very good poem written by him, a world-known poem it is, The Road Not Taken. So let's start our poem. As you can see, very first, some lines are written. Let's read it out. This well-known poem is about making choices and the choices that shape us. Robert Frost is an American poet who writes simply but insightfully about common, ordinary experiences. So this is the poet about choices. Choices that we always have. Some kind of choices about very simple thing, but some kind the choices about very crucial decision of life. But choices that always we have. And we have to just pay attention towards our choices, because after making choice, after selecting one path, we have to decide, or we have to face the decision, we have to face the result of that choice. We cannot run away, we cannot go away from that result. So choices that always we have in our life. So let's start our poem. In this poem, The Road Not Taken, the road symbolizes, as the name of the poem is, The Road Not Taken. The road that is not taken by the poet. Taken the road here, the road symbolizes our life. The poet says that the path that we don't choose in our life is the road not taken. Sometime for a thing, you are having two choices, and you choose the first one and you left the another choice. So here he is talking about that left one choices that you did not select in your life. That symbolizes the poem The Road Not Taken. He describes his feelings about the choices that he had left in the past. We all have left a few of the choices in our past. The path which we have selected, it always decides our future, our destination. The important message that the poet wants to give is that the choice that we make has an impact on our future always. And if we make a wrong choice in our life, we regret it. We always regret it, but cannot go back on it. You cannot go back to your past and you cannot erase all that happened to you. So we must be wise while making choices. You all must be wise while making our choices, because the thing you have selected, the choices you have made in your life, you cannot go back and you cannot erase all that memories, and you cannot reverse what already happened to you. So he is giving a very important advice to all of us, that we all have to make our choices very wisely, because this all is going to affect our future. So let's read out the poem stanza by stanza and understand the meaning. Very first, the poet has written, two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, and be one traveler, long I stood, and looked down on one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. What is the meaning of diverged? Diverge means separated. When two things are separated, that is called diverged. Then yellow wood. What is the meaning of yellow wood? Yellow wood symbolizes here the forest, the jungle. Yellow wood, forest area. Then undergrowth, dense growth of plants and bushes. What is the meaning of undergrowth? Dense growth of plants and bushes. Now let's start the meaning of this line. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Two roads separated in a yellow wood. You got the meaning here? Two roads diverged in the yellow wood. So let's assume that once the poet was walking down on a road and then there was a diversion. There was a separation and there were two different paths and he had to choose one out of them as he cannot travel the both. The line, if you will see, and sorry, I could not travel both. So what the meaning of poet here as he cannot walk on the both of the paths together. So he has to choose one. Then he had to choose one out of these two roads and be one traveler, long I stood. So the poet, he said, long I stood there. The poet says that as he was one person, he could not travel on both the roads simultaneously. So he had to choose one out of these two roads in the yellow wood. And yellow wood means here in the forest. The poet had to choose one out of these two roads in the yellow wood. And here he means a forest with leaves which are wearing out and they have turned yellow in color. That is why the poet has used yellow wood here. The season of autumn is going on and it represents a world which is full of people, where people have been living for many years. They represent people and who are older than the poet, as the leaves are yellow. The poet kept standing there and looked at the path very carefully. If you will read the line, be one traveler, long I stood, that he kept standing on the path there for a very long time to observe both the path very carefully, as far as he could see it before taking the path. He wanted to know how it was, how both the path is. Was it suitable for him or no? Then he was able to see the path till from where it curved, after which it was covered with the yellow leaves. So you will see, long I stood, looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. So he stood there for a long time to observe both the path and what kind of situation both the roads have so that he can choose one out of them. Let's move toward our next stanza. I hope you got the meaning of first stanza. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Two roads were separated in a yellow wood in the forest. And poet is saying, sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveler, he is saying, as I cannot choose both the path and I have to choose one road. Long I stood, he stood long there for a long time and looked down one as far as I could, and he stood there for a long time to observe both the road to where it bent in the undergrowth, that what is the condition of both the roads. Now let's go to the next stanza. Then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. Let's start this paragraph again. Then took the other just as fair. So let's pay attention towards the meaning of this, an important meaning of this stanza. Fair means as good as the other one, as both the roads were very good. So he used the word fair for both the roads, that both are very good. Claim, the meaning claim here is better option. That which one road is claiming that I am the better one. Claim the better option. Grassy means unused. What is the meaning of grassy here? Unused. When the path is grassy means nobody walked over it. It's grassy. It's unused. Wanted wear had not been used. Again, the meaning is same. Wanted wear, when the thing is not used, when the path is not used by anyone. Wanted wear. So let's start the meaning of this stanza. The poet kept on looking at one path for a long time to check if it is the right path for him or not, because he has to choose one road from them, from both of them. So he stood there for a long time to check which one is the right or which one is the Rome, as he had to decide only one. And then he started walking on another path. So he chose his path because he felt that the both paths were equally good. He cannot decide, he is not able to decide that which one path he shall take. So he took the one, as both are equally good. He says just as fair, so he felt that both paths were equally good and started walking on one of them. He adds that maybe he felt that the path was better for him, so he chooses it as it had grass on it, which means that it was unused. That the poet wants to say that he took the another road, that it was also just as fair as the first one, and having perhaps the better claim that both the roads are very good, but I took the one from them. So, and why he chose, then later on he is giving one idea that why he chose second one, that maybe it was grassy, it was unused, it was wanted wear, so that is why he chose the second one road. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. So later on he says that not many people had walked on the path earlier, that is why this path was grassy and wanted wear, means that it was not walked over by many people. After he walked on the path for some distance, he realized that both the paths had been worn out the same way. Both the paths were similar and worn out. Even in our life, we take any path or option, but all of them have the same benefits, disadvantages, problems, challenges, and we must face them. We have to face our challenges, because on every path you will get the challenges, you will get the advantages as well as the disadvantages. So though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. So when he was now walking on the second road, he is thinking, or he notified that both the roads are same and both the roads have its advantages and disadvantages. So students, our two strangers are finished here. Two road diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, and it is finished till here. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. Rest of the poem we will do in our next session. What you all have to do, read out the poem. Please try to understand what the Robert Frost wants to say here. What is his idea behind this poem? What exactly the meaning of this poem, as we have already discussed that here the two roads reflect the choices in our life. We all have to make our choices very wisely. We all have to take the decision in our life very wisely. Always we are getting choices in our life. Sometimes getting choices about a very simple thing, and sometimes getting choices about a very crucial things in our life, the things that are very important for us. So whenever we are getting the choices, whenever you all are getting some choice about something, always think about something, always make your decision wisely, always think deep about the result of your choice, and then decide something for the better, because your choice is going to create your future. You cannot blame anyone about it, and you cannot move into the past, and you cannot erase all that thing, you cannot turn all that thing. So rest of the poem we will do in our next session. Stay safe in the house, read out the poem again, try to get the meaning of this. Stay safe in the house.